Meet Clementine. She's a policymaker and is working on a long-term strategy that ensures her country's prosperity despite the climate crisis. She knows that climate change threatens people, the national economy, and different industries more and more. She needs to plan accordingly to make the country's economy resilient to these climate impacts. In her country, just like in many other places in the world, the agriculture sector is one of the most vulnerable to climate change. Right now, she has a limited budget and three options for adaptation measures that could help better manage climate risks. Building irrigation canals and water reservoirs to protect against droughts. Planting windbreaks to protect against extreme wind. Or constructing dikes to protect against floods. Clementine calls Eric, a policymaker working at the Ministry of Economy, to learn if there is a way to forecast how adaptation measures affect the long-term economic development. Eric explains that he just recently heard from the Global Program on Climate Resilient Economic Development, CRED. They developed climate-sensitive macroeconomic models for Kazakhstan, Vietnam, and Georgia. With such macroeconomic models, different possible scenarios based on available climate and economic data can be developed in order to quantify the economy-wide impacts of adaptation measures. The colleagues agree that this is just what they need. Our policymakers now need to go through a five-step process. Collect the necessary economic and climate data. Use these data to build the country-specific macroeconomic model. Do scenario analysis, which basically means comparing the outcomes of different adaptation measures to a situation where no adaptation action is taken. Make sense of the results and draw conclusions from the comparison, and decide which adaptation measure to select. When it comes to implementation, the decision makers consider the results of the modeling and other political priorities. The modeling results and selected adaptation measures are then included in the long-term strategy, a plan to make their country more climate resilient. Clementine and Eric are very optimistic of this plan, especially as they have Kazakhstan's success story right in front of them. An assessment by the CRED program focused on adaptation in Kazakhstan's agriculture sector showed that investments in the irrigation infrastructure could increase the GDP up to 1.2% per year and even create up to 78,000 additional jobs annually in comparison to a situation where no adaptation action is taken. Some time has passed. Clementine and Eric have gone through all steps and decided which adaptation measure to include in the long-term strategy for climate resilience. They are very content with the results from the three scenario analyses. They provide crucial guidance on which adaptation measure their country's economy would benefit from the most over the next 30 years. Now they can use the results on the long-term economic benefits of this measure to mobilize finances for the adaptation investment. Your country can also develop its own climate-sensitive macroeconomic model and employ this approach to ensure economic planning is sound and takes climate risks into account. For more information on this methodology, the experts from GIZ are glad to advise you.